Hey guys, the question is, Crane Industries carries no inventories. Its products is manufactured only when a customer's order is received. It is then shipped immediately after it is made. For its fiscal year ended October 31st, 2020, Crane's break-even point was $1.38 million on sales of $1.18 million. Its income statement showed a gross profit of $213,000, and here is our other data. So here, first of all, we had to calculate variable selling and administrative expenses. So variable selling and administrative expenses. So here, sales and contribution margin are given. So here our total variable expenses will be sales minus contribution margin. Here sales, total sales is of $1.18 million. So $1,180,000 less contribution margin $177,000. So it is equal to 1,000. Total variable expenses is equal to $3,000. Now, as we know that total variable expenses are equal to direct material cost, direct labor cost, and variable selling and variable manufacturing overheads and variable selling and administrative expenses. So here, variable selling and administrative expenses will be equal to our total variable expenses less direct material cost less direct labor cost less variable manufacturing overheads. So here total variable expenses $3,000 less direct material cost $401,000 less direct labor cost $500,000 less variable manufacturing overhead $48,000. So the answer is $54,000. Variable selling and administrative expenses are equal to $54,000. Now, fixed manufacturing overhead. Fixed manufacturing overhead. So here, cost of goods sold is equal to direct material, direct labor, direct material plus direct labor cost plus variable manufacturing overhead plus fixed manufacturing overhead. So here, first of all, we will calculate cost of goods sold. Sales minus gross profit. Here, sales is of $1,180,000 less gross profit $213,000, so is equal 1,180,000 minus $213,000, so $967,000. Now our fixed manufacturing overheads are equal to cost of goods sold less direct material cost less direct labor cost, less variable manufacturing overhead cost. So here our cost of goods sold 967,000 minus direct material cost $401,000 less direct labor cost $500,000 less variable manufacturing overhead $48,000. So here it is equal to $18,000. Our fixed manufacturing overheads are $18,000. Now the third part is fixed selling and administrative expenses. So fixed selling and administrative expenses are, first of all, contribution margin ratio. Fixed selling and administrative expenses. So first of all, contribution margin ratio. Contribution margin divided by sales. Here contribution margin is of 177,000 divided by sales is of 180,000. So here it is equal to 15%. Now we will calculate break-even point. Total fixed cost divided by contribution margin ratio. Here our break-even point is given, which is break-even point 1.38 million dollar. So $1,380,000 is equal to total fixed cost. Here total fixed cost, we will calculate total fixed cost divided by contribution margin ratio 15%. So total fixed cost is equal to 1380,000 multiplied by 15% is, so $207,000 our total fixed cost. So here total fixed cost, so our fixed selling and administrative expenses will be total fixed cost, which is 207,000 less fixed manufacturing overheads. Our fixed manufacturing overheads are $18,000. So here it is equal to $189,000. So here are our solutions. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon.